I'm Charlie. I'm a consultant general colorectal surgeon at the University Hospital of Coventry in Warwickshire. Some patients will develop worrying symptoms with their bowels. This may be a change in bowel habits, they may develop diarrhea, they may notice some blood within their stool. They may also find that they have a mass within their tummy or have unusual pains. These will need investigating. The most usual test for the bowels is a colonoscopy or a flexible sigmoidoscopy. Alternatively, sometimes you may have imaging such as a CT scan. If these tests find a worrying lesion, this will need further investigation. If these investigations identify a worrying lesion, there is a high chance that this could be a bowel cancer. All bowel cancers need complete staging, which includes a CT scan of your chest, abdomen and pelvis, but also if the lesion is within the lower bowel, the rectum, you will also need an MRI scan of the pelvis. Once all this imaging has been performed and the information from the test put together, it will be discussed at a multidisciplinary team meeting where you have cancer specialists, bowel surgeon specialists, pathologists and x-ray doctors. A lot of patients at this point will be referred onto surgeons for an operation to remove the tumour. These operations are generally done by specialist colorectal surgeons and can be done either as open operation or keyhole operations. The majority of surgeons doing keyhole operations do them as standard laparoscopic operations, however an increasing number are performing them robotically. Robotic surgery in the UK is most commonly performed using the DaVinci device made by Intuitive. There are three parts to the robotic device: the surgeon console, the patient sidecar, and the vision sack. The surgeon sits at the console while the patient has the sidecar attached to instruments that go within the patient's abdomen. The surgeon console allows a surgeon to see in 3D high definition within the body. This is really important when you're trying to operate in a precise way in a narrow, difficult area. There also is control of the instrument through the console. The surgeon uses pincers to move the instrument, so as the surgeon moves his hand, the instrument is carefully and precisely moved within the patient's abdomen, again to ensure that everything is done in a controlled manner to avoid any damage. The instruments that are used within the patient are inserted through normal laparoscopic ports into the patient, but they are attached to the patient's sidecars. This enables these instruments to have extra functions that normal laparoscopic ones don't have. Normal laparoscopic instruments open and close without any other range of movement. However, the robotic ones have an articulating wrist. This enables the surgeon to work their way around bends, which is particularly important when you're trying to operate down in the pelvis. Any patient with rectal cancer will require surgery within their pelvis. The pelvis is a very challenging place to operate because it is a confined space and carries important pelvic nerves and blood vessels. The nerves supply urinary and sexual function, and the blood vessels drain not only the pelvis but also supply the blood supply to the lower limbs. When operating on rectal cancer, it is very important that not only do you remove the cancer but also the lining of the bowel with it, so as this reduces the risk of recurrence. It is important that you perform a total mesorectal excision. I believe that robotic surgery in colorectal cancer has many benefits to the patient and the surgeon. There are the benefits of reducing the risk of converting to an open operation. You have precise operating, avoiding the risk to damage to nerves and blood vessels. I also believe it offers the greatest chance of removing the cancer in a safe way to reduce the risk of recurrence.